Gridify and the gap tool. These are pretty cool features. I don't know when they were added to InDesign, but they are here now. It works with any shape of frame, shape, or text boxes. What it does is when you click and drag to make a shape, if before you let go of the mouse, if you use the arrow keys, it will create a grid for you. And the gap tool, what that does is it adjusts the gaps between them. If you click and hold, it will tell you how big those gaps are. If you drag, it adjusts in that way. If you hold down Command, it adjusts in a different way. If you hold Option, it adjusts in a different way. And if you hold Shift, it will adjust in yet a different way. So this also, as I said, it also works with any shape of frame. And if you hold Shift, it will maintain the proportions like it usually does. Now this also leads into my next slide, which is placing multiple images at the same time. Now the optional check auto fit, my toolbar up here isn't quite long enough for me to have that option readily available, so I'm not gonna do that. But that's something that you can look for if you have a desktop size computer with a larger monitor. So placing a number of images at the same time. Command D is a shortcut to place images. And I am going to choose a bunch of images here. Because I've chosen more than one, I get a loaded cursor, and that little icon of the picture has a number in parentheses next to it. That tells me how many images I have loaded, and the left and right arrow keys will allow me to scroll through all of those images. And if I decide that I don't want one, I can hit Escape, and it will be discarded. And then I can click on the frames, and it will place them for me.